Good morning, St. Alphonsus. Today is Monday after Pentecost. Veni Sancta Spiritus. Come Holy Spirit. It's also Monday of the ninth week of Ordinary Time, and it's the memorial of the Blessed Virgin, Mary, Mother of our Church. Today's readings come from Genesis chapter 3, verses 9 through 15 and verse 20, and we have an optional first reading from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, verses 12 through 14. The Gospel is from John, chapter 19, verses 25 through 34. I encourage you to read all three of them, not to choose between one or the other of the first two readings, because there's an interesting thread that runs through them. First of all, we've got Eve as the mother of all the living, and that's why Adam names her Eve. And then we've got Mary, who's with the apostles after the ascension of Jesus. She's praying in an upper chamber of the place where they're staying, and they're praying as with one accord. And then in the gospel, Mary and the blessed disciple are with Jesus at the foot of the cross. Jesus, to emphasize how important Mary is to our faith, tells Mary, "Woman, this is your son," referring to the blessed disciple. And to the disciple, "This is your mother." Mary is the mother of all of us who follow Jesus, who love, cherish, worship, and honor Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Mary was the first disciple. Think about it. The angel came down, spoke with Mary, and said, "God has chosen you. Will you accept? Will you be the mother of Jesus, the Son of God, whose kingdom will never end?" Mary says yes. Mary is with Jesus throughout his life, most obviously at his birth, but later she's with him when they go to the temple for Passover, and he stays behind speaking with the learned, and they have to go back and find him. She's with Jesus at his first miracle, at the wedding of Cana, where he turns water into wine. She's with Jesus at his death. She's with the disciples after Jesus' ascension. Mary is an important part of our faith. And we can contrast that with Eve at the very first, in the first reading from Genesis, where Adam and Eve both disobey God and they eat of the forbidden fruit. Mary says yes, they say no. Many times in my life I have said no. I have not followed the will of the Father. I wish to be more like Mary. I pray to be more like Mary. This day after Pentecost, I pray that the Holy Spirit's with me and gives me the strength and the grace to follow the will of the Father as Mary did. This is my prayer for me. This is my prayer for you. This is my prayer for all of us. Amen.